Titan submersible, which was recovered from the floor of the Atlantic on Wednesday. Investigators hope the wreckage will help determine the cause of the catastrophic implosion, which killed all five people on board. CNN's Paula Newton has details.
The U.S. Coast Guard announced that it had found what it presumed to be human remains on the sea floor. That would be from the submersible Titan. They recovered these remains and now say that the United States medical professionals will conduct a formal analysis of those presumed human remains. And of course, the family and friends of those five passengers who died on the Titan, they will be comforted by this, but also will feel again profound grief given what the U.S. Coast Guard says was an implosion of that Titan submergible. What's also happening now is that on Wednesday, the Horizon Arctic retrieved debris, in fact, large pieces of debris. They say that they have finished their work out there at the site of the Titanic wreck. And what's extraordinary here is that they did, in fact, recover large pieces of that debris. You can see, in fact, the dome with the viewport and a good chunk even of the passenger frame. Again, at issue here is that carbon fiber material that was used to hold those passengers and was used in this kind of deep sea exploration. The U.S. Coast Guard says that now they will begin to examine all of it. And again, there are many investigations underway, including here in Canada. That investigation expected to take well over a year. Paula Newton, CNN, Ottawa.
Juliet Kam joins me now. She's a former assistant secretary at the Department of Homeland Security. She now teaches at Harvard University. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Okay, right now, it's still not known how much the search and rescue operation for the Titan sub actually cost. The US government apparently is working on that number, but you know, notably Canada sent more assets into this search. France was involved as well. But as an indication of the costs, here's part of a report from the Washington Post. Three C-17 cargo planes delivered equipment from Buffalo to staging points in Newfoundland. Those flights cost an estimated $491,000 round trip. So, you know, that would seem to be a tiny fraction of the, you know, the ultimate cost here. So in terms of resources committed to this search and how much it's going to end up costing at the end of the day, what's your assessment here?
It's going to be much more expensive than the low numbers around $1 million that we initially heard. If you just think of man or woman power behind essentially a week-long effort, you are going to get large numbers. And this question of the magnitude of the search and rescue is different, and I want to make clear, is different than should there have been a rescue. Absolutely, under international conventions, under international search and rescue conventions, every country has an obligation to help a vessel that is under distress. So for some period of time, there might have been an assumption that they could have either survived or that the submarine was floating, and if they could just find it, then they could save people. Essentially, over time, though, that became clear that was not the fact. And the magnitude of the resources that went to an incident that we call in disaster management low probability and essentially low consequence raises a concern that those resources were spent because not because of the sort of rescue, but because of who was in it and the public pressure to do something.
Well, Pentagon spokesman Brigadier General Patrick Ryder, he was asked about the cost of the Titan search last week. This is what he said.
When it comes to things like operating aircraft, those come from appropriated funds which are already budgeted for. So those are hours that already have been paid.
Yeah, the cost may have already been budgeted, but the money still had to come from somewhere, right? Just because it's in the budget doesn't mean it's free.
Exactly. Look, I mean, any expenditure of funds in one place is going to take away eventually funds from another place. So that either we should own up to the amount that was spent and have a reason for why that much money was spent, or begin to have an honest discussion about risk and probability and the necessity to deploy our search and rescue resources, whether it's a submarine or it's a holdouts on an island who won't evacuate during a hurricane, or hikers who are careless and threaten first responders because they have to be saved. You know, all of those are really hard questions, but they're ones that the disaster management community is asking right now, because I think we haven't seen the final price tag But one has to suspect it's quite high.
Yeah, and again, just to stress the point, this is not about, you know, not helping people who are in distress.
Exactly.
But what makes this contrast so great is that while the world was fixated on the search for the Titan submersible and five very, very wealthy people in that submersible, well, the New York Times had this headline. Five deaths at sea gripped the world. Hundreds of others got a shrug. And those others were the 750 migrants who died when their battered boat capsized off the coast of Greece, and a point not lost on former President Barack Obama. Here he is.
Right now we have 24-hour coverage, and I understand it, of this submarine, the submersible. At the same time, right here, in just off the coast of Greece, we had 700 people dead.
And what makes it even worse is that the Greek Coast Guard did not offer assistance until it was way too late. And it comes down really to a question of priorities, right?
Right, it does. And what the Greek Coast Guard did was not pursuant to their own obligations, moral obligations, but also to treaties that all Coast Guards are under, which is a vessel is in distress, you do not ask questions. It does not matter what they were doing or where they were going or whether it was lawful or not. It is a community of response efforts that all agree that a ship under distress should be saved. But that, as you said, that does not get to the magnitude. And I think with the submarine, with the Titan, we conflated high interest with sort of high consequence, right? I mean, in other words, this idea that this submarine had a bigger story than that unfortunately five people were lost, it sort of animated the world. We can understand why it had, you know, it had billionaires and the Titanic and all of our fears of, you know, getting caught somewhere with consciousness of death. I get it, but it does not explain the amount of resources that were spent
Please join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MCAD TV family. Please like and share MCAD TV. We love you all. Please support MCAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.